That's what I really crave.
Mm-hmm.
To work with people who want to invest that time to really carve out that character, which happened with Tare Zameen Par, and that was iconic. So when Madhur explained the character to me, I sat down with him and I said, you know, this woman has a heart. She has a reason for cheating on her husband or for wanting to pursue a relationship outside of her marriage. They're not looking at me for perfection in the way that I look. They're looking to see my heart in that part. Wow, that rhymes.
So this is very surreal for me because I have grown up loving Kahani Ghar Ghar Ki. And you played a very important role in that show.
Yes.
You were responsible for making Parvati's life quite miserable at many points.
many people would say that I'm responsible for making their lives quite miserable.
My first question for you is, let's talk about Hostages. You know, your big debut on Hotstar this year. What has the response been like?
Fabulous. Not to say that I didn't expect it.
Yeah.
The guys at Hotstar warned me.
Yeah.
They told me that you have no clue how big this is going to be.
Right.
And then when it did become big, I was like, whoa.
Yeah.
And not just in India, but also internationally.
Yeah.
And I'm so glad that people have connected with the character.
Right.
It's not your typical sort of person.
Right.
And I love playing her.
Yeah.
So it's been very grateful.
Yeah. But you know, you're one of the few actors from our industry who has balanced film, television and digital with equal ease. Do you feel the pressure of how do you maintain that balance, or is that ever on your shoulders?
I don't think one looks at my work like that.
Yeah.
You know, you look at the story, the
right.
overall story,
right.
and then you look at your part.
Right.
And then you look at the people who are making it.
Yeah.
And I think, and then you look at the check.
Yeah.
So those are the things that you
of
look
course.
At.
Yeah.
And you say, all right, if it's a great story
yes.
that needs telling, and if it's a good role, something
yeah.
that I haven't done before.
Yeah.
Then it doesn't really matter. But television, not so much at all right now.
Right.
Mainly film and web.
Yeah, yeah. Do you think web has, I mean, it obviously has, but in terms of opening up opportunities, in terms of roles, because television obviously does stereotype you in certain ways. So what sort of roles have you been exploring and what sort of roles are you expecting to do on web in the coming year?
The web is a... complete uncharted new territory. It's
yeah.
like the promised land.
Yeah.
Everyone's rushing.
Right.
The kind of roles that the web space is offering very talented actors who
yeah.
probably didn't have the sort of alpha drive to push
mm-hmm.
themselves in the film space to
mm-hmm.
that extent
mm-hmm.
are doing great work
yeah.
on the web space. For example, Pankaj Tripathi, fabulous actor,
mm-hmm.
is a complete product of success on the web.
Correct.
You know?
Correct.
Of course, he's done very good work in films as well.
Yeah.
But he's leading web series.
Sure.
You know?
Sure.
So that is great. For me, I think the web has... I think I'm born too early in that sense.
Okay.
I should have been born a millennial.
Okay.
Because I adapted to the web like that.
Right.
For me, the whole web space, the whole idea of understanding content
yeah.
and the kind of content I like.
Yeah.
I consume the web voraciously. I'm watching web series all
right.
the time.
Right.
Any work that I've done on the web has just gone absolutely viral.
Yeah.
So whether it's Chutney, the short film.
Correct.
Then there's Churiya, next one.
Yes.
Then there's one, you know, like a sort of video I'd done called The Reptile Dysfunction.
Yes, yes, yes.
That went viral.
Yeah.
Then Hostages. So everything that I've done on the web has
right.
just like been fabulously accepted. So I think that the resonance with the kind of audience that watches the web and me
yeah.
and the kind of work I like to do,
yeah.
there's a fabulous sort of...
synchronization.
Yeah,
or,
yeah,
yeah.
yeah. So
yeah.
I'm really thrilled.
Yeah.
I'm very, very happy.
You know, there's a lot of debate and rhetoric right now around feminism and the way we're portraying women on screen and gender on screen. And you've produced also. So do you, what sort of responsibility do you feel in terms of when you're picking a role or when you're ideating upon something in terms of what the end viewer is going to feel when they see it?
You know, I'll tell you a very small incident that happened
yeah.
Around a film. I did a film called Dil To Bachcha Hai Ji with
yes.
Madhur Bhandarkar.
Yes.
And I was playing this sort of cougar character
mm-hmm.
who's attracted to her trainer, who
mm-hmm.
was Imran Hashmi, and she's married to a much older man. So when Madhur explained the character to me, I sat down with him and I said, you know, this woman has a heart. she has a reason for cheating on her husband mm-hmm. or for wanting to pursue a relationship outside of her marriage.
Yeah.
What is that reason? We yeah. never see that. We just slot people, women as yeah, 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 yeah.
Homewrecker and or, you know, yeah, whatever. Yeah, yeah, yeah. whatever. Yeah.
So, why is she stepping outside her marriage? Let's consider that for a moment. Mm-hmm. Let's think about that. Let's see her heart.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see her field
sure.
of her.
Sure.
Because otherwise, we're just getting into the stereotype of hum dur se dekh rahe.
Mm-hmm.
And I told Madhur, I said, you could have afforded this when you were a new director, when you were a person who was sort of making page 3 because mm-hmm. you were looking at page 3 people from
mm-hmm.
outside.
Mm-hmm.
But today, you're Madhur Bhandarkar who arrives in a Merc SUV. So you're not someone who's on the outside. So if you see a cougar, you would probably have access to her mental landscape to understand
sure.
why she is that.
Sure.
You're not a young boy looking at an older woman who's having an affair with a younger man.
Right.
You have now reached a place in your own life where you can slice off some of her social paint and see what's going on with her.
Mm-hmm.
And I think I'm interested in exploring that. So we actually put in a scene into the film where her husband comes in and he says, look, I don't have time for all of this. Why don't you go shopping, you know, go with your
yeah,
friends
yeah.
on a trip, do something else.
Yeah.
I've got too much work to do. And which is when she craves that affection and that
right.
attention. So
right.
it's not just fulfilling her bodily need,
sure.
which is how we see.
We assume it's that. Yeah.
Just that.
Yeah.
That's fine too.
Yeah.
I mean, women have bodily needs and
sure.
I've got no problem with
sure.
that. All I'm saying is there's like, that can't be all.
Yeah.
So that's what I like to explore. So I have collaborations and discussions with directors, and I found that most people are very, very open. They're
yeah.
very open to discussing all of this, because I think the whole understanding, the zeitgeist of the time, is that everyone understands that the portrayal of women has not been right.
Right.
It's been very unidimensional.
As a producer, you know, Chutney, I read somewhere 124 million views,
25.
Oh, 25 now on YouTube. So from the production standpoint, what do you see happening next? And do you feel like you have a benchmark that you have to reach and you have to hit that same benchmark again? Or are you taking it easy?
I suffered with that when the film came out and became this 125 million
sure.
cult classic.
Sure.
And it wasn't just like a mainstreamy, like a sort of...
Yeah.
You know, it wasn't like a Sex and Sleaze film.
Right, right.
It
made a point.
It made
yeah.
many points.
Yeah.
And I like the fact that there's badassery and there's
yeah.
a kind of like a sarcastic humor in it
right.
and all of that.
Right.
And I wrote it. Firstly, it was a relief.
Yeah.
The first reaction was, oh my God, wow.
It's
so what
worked.
I've been thinking
yeah.
in my head as something that may work actually does work. So
yeah.
that was a relief.
Yeah.
And then gratitude for people having this kind of love for it. And then we tried to sort of benchmark ourselves against that
mm-hmm.
and we failed.
Mm-hmm.
So now I think I've freed myself from that. Every project has its own destiny and it's going to give you different kinds of learnings and you're going to have different kinds of fun with it.
Yeah. How do you reinvent yourself with every role?
I think the role tells you
mm-hmm.
what it needs.
Mm-hmm.
So there is no particular one method to go for it. But if you have enough time to live with that part, to sort of investigate into various aspects of the character,
yeah.
And spend that's a luxury.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I really crave.
Mm-hmm.
To work with people who want to invest that time
mm-hmm.
to really carve out that character,
mm-hmm.
which happened with Tare Zameenpur, and that was
sure.
iconic then.
Right.
Because there was such a sense of sort of developing that role
mm-hmm.
layer,
mm-hmm.
by layer by
mm-hmm.
layer by layer by
mm-hmm.
layer. And while shooting the film, I had this like a little, no one knew about it. So this Dhobi ka diary, you know,
mm-hmm.
we have this little chota.
Ha, they keep track of all the,
yeah,
you
yeah,
know,
yeah,
all
yeah.
the, yeah, yeah.
So we have that little tiny diary, which is like a diary where you write
mm-hmm.
how many clothes.
How many clothes?
And
yeah.
So I wrote that, and I wrote the Dhobi diary, and I wrote like a little hisab of the vegetables on the back of it, and you know, I was sort of calculating how much, what kind of milk will Ishan be having,
mm-hmm.
what kind of milk will Johan be having, what is their father sort of, you know, what does he like and what do I
mm-hmm.
need to order, how do I... So I made a little hisab kitab of that. And I just wrote that and I kept it in one of the drawers,
mm-hmm.
which no one in production knew, no one knew.
Mm-hmm.
And I had to just go check it every day and see, yeah, it's there and whatever. So that diary was like sort of my idea of how I'm running this house.
Wow.
And what's going on. But it never came into any part
mm-hmm.
of the
yeah.
film, you never
yeah.
saw it. But it was just like, that just really helped me. It was like a thing. It was just
yeah.
there. And it
yeah.
just sort of, you know, kind of helps you to bind into what's going on.
Right.
And suddenly I'm thinking, oh God, I better write this. Yeah, this is going to be extra. And so it helps to structure your framework as a woman who's looking at these two children and this one man who's perpetually touring mm-hmm. and what's going on. So, you mm-hmm. know, the character will tell you what it sort of wants to be done with it.
Yeah. How do you keep up with the pulse of the audience? You know, audiences are changing every day. How do you, you know, stay updated with what's going on and who's liking what and what's going to work and what's not going to work?
The camera is a very magical piece of equipment.
Yeah.
It catches your intent.
Mm-hmm.
It catches your truth.
Mm-hmm.
If you're investing your heart,
yeah,
then the audience wants that heart. They want to be touched. They want to be moved. They want to laugh. They want to cry. But they want you to be vulnerable. They want to be able to see you.
Right.
With all your flaws and chinks.
Yeah.
They no longer care about the plasticness of you.
Mm-hmm.
Because there's enough of that. There's ads, there's this, there's the whole glossy,
mm-hmm.
You know, single cinema release, etc.
Yeah.
They're not looking at me for perfection in the way that I look.
Mm.
They're looking to see my heart in that part.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, that rhymes.
Yeah.
But that's what I think will always work.
Do you know, as someone who's heavily involved in the digital space, do you ever think about sort of the saturation, oversaturation, undersaturation? Because now everybody is coming up with a digital platform, right? Every cable channel has their own platform. Does that worry you in terms of the sort of the sudden explosion? Do you think is there going to be a compromise on quality, or how are we going to control that?
If I was a channel owner or a platform owner, then I'd be worried. But I'm an actor, so
sure.
You know, or a producer. So for me, I'm sort of like not really that involved with that end of things.
Yeah.
So for me, what's interesting is that there's a lot more work for the industry, which is always great.
Yeah.
It's very flush with work.
Mm-hmm.
There's you know, the economy outside seems to be sort of, you know, going through its own troubles.
Yeah.
The Sensex is going up and down, but the mm-hmm. entertainment business is booming.
Yeah.
So there is a huge amount of finance that's flowed into the business, which is great.
Right. Sure.
But I do think it's a bit of the gold rush. Everyone's kind of rushing in there. There's a web series. There will be a shakedown.
Yeah.
And a bunch of the platforms will sort of come together and
mm-hmm.
form one
mm-hmm.
broad thing. They'll, you know, sort of form a...
Sure. An alliance or...
Not even an alliance. I think they'll just like come together and form one thing, one
mm-hmm.
unit. Because right now it's very fragmented and...
Mm-hmm.
Just about any kind of content is okay to make,
which
is also good because a lot of new, younger people are just going on a very thin idea and going out there and trying their stuff and probably going to make something better when they, you know, have more experience and understand how much more they can do with it. It is a bit of a gold rush.
Yeah. You know, you talked about finances. As an actor, how do you manage, you know, there's a commercial side of the business and there's a critical acclaim side of the business. And you've seen it both. So when selecting a project, how do you strike that balance, or is it one or the other?
There was a time when I started working and I was all about the role, and I was, you know, I'd really get enamored with that part and start seeing images and be really salivating to play that part.
Yeah.
But then I understood that a film needs heft behind it.
Mm-hmm.
It's like that analogy of, you know, winking at somebody in the dark.
Sure.
Nobody knows. It's just like, you know, you've done it.
Sure.
So you don't really make... This particular art form is not meant to be consumed just by you. It's to be consumed by the audience.
Yeah.
And for that, it needs a certain number of theaters. It needs a certain
mm-hmm.
amount of publicity and advertising, P&A money to be able to put it out there. So I am a lot more careful with the kind of projects I take up in terms of course, the story has to be good and the role has to be good. But
mm-hmm.
I also try and make sure that it will see the light of day.
Yeah.
Because if it doesn't, then it's a whole lot of effort for no reason. I mean,
yeah.
you're just like they make a videotape out of it, or they send you a Vimeo link, password protected, and then you're watching it and you're saying, oh man, I wish this film would come out and it would be so good and whatever.
Right.
But then come out.
Yeah.
And that's no fun.
Yeah. But do you think with the whole digitization, the distribution outlets have improved, and that these concerns maybe are getting
Certainly, yes, the digital medium does make sure that even films that were otherwise not going to come out are going to come out, and at least people will see it.
Correct.
You know.
Correct.
That's crucial.
Yeah. Yeah. What is the future of the theatrical film?
A bit in jeopardy, I would say.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I don't think that community viewing experience is going to go away.
Sure.
I think it's going to stay, but I think that cinema will have to then give you that experience. Mm-hmm. It will demand that darkened hall mm-hmm. for you to go and see it and mm-hmm. for you to want to mm-hmm. face the traffic, pay that extra money, because you know, in like if three or four people are going, then that's the cost of your subscription for an entire year almost. Absolutely. And you're like, should I not just pay this for a year?
Yeah.
And people are, India is a very money conscious market.
And for a middle class family, a family of five to go and see a film, it's still quite pricey. Yeah.
Yeah. But then it becomes an experience about, you know, going out and then we catch dinner and then we, you know, do ice cream afterwards and maybe pan after that. Yeah. You know, that's the whole family experience.
Sure.
So that might still continue, but it will go down. It has gone down. It will continue to go down.
Yeah.
So the theatrical experience will have to be, people will have to specifically sculpt movies for the big screen experience.
Yeah.
That will become the norm.
Yeah. But speaking of audiences, you know, people say, oh, the audiences are changing and audience tastes are changing. But, you know, the average viewer of a show like Astitva or Kahani Ghar Ghar Ki, do you think they're going to eventually become the audience for your web platform, or is the audience going to be completely different?
Hopefully the audience that was watching a series like Astitva or Kahani Ghar Ghar Ki. Kahani Ghar Ghar Ki not so much, Astitva more. Kahani Ghar Ghar Ki is more mainstreamy, sort of commercial, commercial setup. There was no rocket science of a plot there. But the nuanced, what the people who used to watch nuanced content mm-hmm. on television mm-hmm. and were frustrated with what was happening on television are going to go to the web.
Correct.
And there's this whole new audience, which is, you know, the millennials. Who are hooked onto the web. Yeah. They love the web. They couldn't give a shit about television.
Yeah.
Wouldn't give a rat's ass.
Yeah.
So for them, it is the web.
Right.
And features.
Right.
So between that, they will look for stuff. And then for them, the world is the world. So then they will watch Narcos, or they'll watch DOT, or they'll watch, you know, Chernobyl or whatever.
Yeah. You know, speaking about the world, we talk about corporate social responsibility all the time.
CSR.
Absolutely. And now for the media, what level of responsibility do you think we hold towards social reform? Are we just here to entertain, or is there a certain onus that lies on the writers, actors, directors, etc., on the way society is transforming, qualitatively or quantitatively?
I've always believed that movies should not be overly burdened with the idea of reforming the world.
Yeah.
Because you run the risk of becoming preachy.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you then sound like a teacher or like a strict mom, and that's not why you go to the movies.
Right.
You've got enough of that at home.
Sure.
You know, so you don't want parenting when you're watching a movie. Yeah. You want to have fun, you want to chill. But if there is a way in which you can sort of uplift,
mm-hmm.
for example, Aamir does that beautifully.
Sure.
So he does that via A Tare Zameen Par or via A Dangal or even A Three Idiots.
Even A Three Idiots, yeah.
Yeah, definitely A Three Idiots. Yeah. So I'm saying that there's a sense of the work that he's doing, that there is some value that he's putting into, some thought he's putting mm-hmm. into the kind of work he's doing. But it does not reduce the entertainment quotient. Mm-hmm. Their repeat watches of all of these films.
Yeah.
You can watch them any number of times.
Yeah.
But I'm just as big a fan of like a Andaz Apna Apna, which has no message.
Sure.
Who gives a shit?
Sure.
Just have a laugh.
So last but not least, what is that one dream role that you're waiting for? You know, this will just make my, you know, like, you've done so many, so much variety, but what is that one, you know, this kind of role, and you know, I would love to do something like this.
I'd love to do a role like Lavi and Rose, what Manigong Kothiyad did. I think a biopic mm-hmm. would be very interesting,
mm-hmm.
Where you get to play someone who really invests in that character and go through the motions of that life mm-hmm. and understand that life. Mm-hmm. That would be interesting for me. Mm-hmm. A painter perhaps, a performing artist of some type, a singer maybe. That'd be great. That'd be great.
Yeah.
Stuff like that.
Yeah. Awesome, fingers crossed. Thank you so much.
Thank
Thanks again
you.
For your time.
Thank you.